I also welcome the torchbearer of the institute, Principal Dr. B. Sadashiva Gowda, to this session. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, madam.
I welcome Professor and Dean R&D, President of BBCE IIC, Dr. G. B. Krishnappa. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, madam.
I also would like to welcome deans, HODs, and faculty members of various departments. I welcome you all for this session. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce today's session speaker, Dr. Shivanna DM, who has got 16 plus years experience in teaching, research, and industry in the area of vision system, design of aero engine components, marine engine blocks, rail body sheet metal parts, and sheet metal fabrication of CNC machine tools. Dr. Shivanna DM is presently heading MSME Incubation and IP Cell at CMRIT Bengaluru. Also, he was an entrepreneur before joining CMRIT. He has developed Stringwing Furnace, which was registered with Controller of Patents under Design Registration. He has experience in executing funded projects from AICTE and wrote more than 7 research project proposals to different government funding agencies. He is actively involved in NGOs to implement socially useful projects. Also having domain knowledge in silicon carbide material heating elements, training and filing the patents and design registration. Sir has got many patents, funded projects, filed many project proposals, and delivered many technical talks. We are happy to have you for this session, sir. Over to you.
Thank you, thank you, madam. Thank you for doing the lovely session. I'm not such a big this one. Still, I'm a learner. Okay. Good evening to all. Good evening to principal, vice principal, and all adopted departments and faculty. Thanks for giving an opportunity to give or deliver talk on AICT NIST 2019 for students and faculty. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, thank you. Yeah. Now, AICT implemented National Innovation Startup Policy 2019, then trying to establish all higher education institutes to implement the innovation startup. Because if any country wants to develop economically, then innovation is very, very important. Okay, based on the innovation, the GDP of the company rates. Okay, for that reason, now our country also trying to establish in all higher education institutes to start innovation and startup at the education and all education sectors. Now, I'm going to deliver the talk on NIST. Outline of the NIST 2019 strategies and governance, startup enabling institutional infrastructure, nurturing innovations and startups, product ownership rights for technology developed at institutes, organizational capacity, human resource incentives, creating innovation pipeline, a pathway for entrepreneur at institute level, the pedagogy and learning interventions for entrepreneurship development, collaboration, co-creation, business relationship and knowledge exchange, and entrepreneurial impact assessment. Okay, I'm trying to highlight only on NIST policy. Later you can take innovation and startups and IPR. Yeah, strategies and governance at the institution level. Here, entrepreneurship promotion and development should be one of the major dimensions of all higher education institutes. Okay, this is one of the main strategy. Okay, to facilitate innovation and entrepreneurship ecosystem in the organization, there must be a specific objective. Okay, then also associated with performance indicators defined and must be assessed. And implementation of entrepreneurial vision at the institute should achieve through mission statement rather than the stringent control system, because this teaching the subject is easy to refer the books and other resources, but when it comes to the innovation entrepreneurship, okay, there is no some rule. Okay, you have to have a freedom to work, autonomy to execute the task. Otherwise, it's a bit difficult to streamline the innovation entrepreneurship. Okay, for that reason, AICT NIST policy mentioning that, okay, there should be a vision statement rather than stringent control system. And also, resource mobilization plan should be worked out at the institution level for supporting pre-incubation, incubation infrastructure and facilities. Go to the next slide, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Strategies should also involve raising funds, because when we talk about innovation, entrepreneurship or startup, okay, without finance, we cannot do anything. Okay, here, if you have an idea, the idea itself cannot be protected. Okay, you need to nurture that idea into a product. Okay, so that here the nurturing idea into a product that we call as innovation, and to implement the product or launch it in the market that we call as a startup. Okay, to run the successful business that we call as entrepreneurship or startup. Okay, here to convert idea into a product, into a marketable product, and to run the business. Okay, for that we need fund. Okay, here for raising the fund, so where there are various sources from state and central government, such as Department of Science and Technology, Department of Biotechnology, NHRD, AICT, TDB, PIFAC, DSIR, CSIR, BIRAT, instead, NRDC, Startup India, Invest India, MSME, so many are there, and also non-government sources to be encouraged, like CSIR funds, and we can take the funds from NGOs or from the corporate, like Corporate Social Responsibility Fund. Okay. The next one is startup enabling institutional infrastructure. The creation of pre-incubation and incubation at the institute level to nurture innovative idea into a startup. Okay, in higher education institute, there should be undertaken a incubation innovation needed to be organically interlinked. Yeah, because any entrepreneurship or startup involves so many interdepartmental activities. Okay, here one party is knowing the technical know-how, other party is finance, then marketing. Okay, here you are nurturing innovative idea into a product by design thinking, then implementing the prototype, then launching into the market. That is technical know-how, developing the product. Other thing is managing the finance, raising the fund to develop the product and run the industry or entrepreneurs, enterprises, startup. And other thing is, see, once you develop the product, who is your end user? Because just developing the product, innovating the product, and just launching into the market, if there is no end user, it is of no use. Because you are going to invest money, material, and time, and your effort. Okay, so that here you need to plan such a way that one party is developing the product by using your intellect, that is the technical know-how. Other party is managing the finance, and third one is marketing. Okay, if you balance all three, then one would become a successful startup or enterprise. Here, the goal of the effort should be linked between innovation to enterprises and to successful financial success. Because ultimate aim is to converting your innovative idea to gain something out of it. Otherwise, it is of no use to put your effort, money, time, and material. Okay, that is what here for this reason to gain the this one to gain the finance AICT they develop a NISP to mobilize or to raise the GDP or finance or what you call it, economical growth to the country. Here, all higher education institutes are devised to create facilities within their institution for supporting pre-incubation. Yeah, that is now MHRD. Now it is the Ministry of Education established a separate cell called the Ministry of Innovation cell under that Institute Innovation Council. Okay, and also that is Entrepreneurship Development Cell EDC, then IEDC Innovation. Entrepreneurship Development Cell, then New Gen, IEDC, Startup Cell, Student Clubs, etc. Okay. Here, if you have any idea, then you need to support the students or faculty to nurture that innovative idea into a prototype. For that pre-incubation and incubation required, then once you pre-incubate and incubate to develop that idea into a product, then you need to have an accelerator to accelerate that develop the product, launch the market to run the successful business. Yes, that pre-incubation incubation facility should be available 24/7. It must be available to the students, staff, and faculty of all disciplines and departments across the institution. Not only from institution, from outsiders also, you need to provide the facility. Okay, so that then you'll have the technology exchange and you are able to succeed in the startup or entrepreneurship. Next, nurturing innovations and startups. Here, higher education institutes are expected to establish processes and mechanisms for easy creation and nurturing of startups and enterprises by students. Students may be from UG, undergraduate or postgraduate, and also from research scholars, PhD students. And staff, including temporary or project or research fellow, and also it must be run by faculty, alumni, and potential startup applicants, even from the outside institution. The incubation offer successful to pre-incubation incubation facility to start up by students, staff, and faculty for mutually acceptable time frame. Because as I told you, for teaching the subject, having 2 years experience in handling single subject, it's easy to handle a third year. But when you come to the innovation entrepreneurship, every day you are going to learn new things because you are going to compete with the market world. There so many changes will be there. You need to continuously change the feature of an innovative product. Okay, so that where there must be a separate time frame to drive the pre-incubation incubation. For that reason, institution have to provide a mutual acceptable time frame to students and staff and also faculty members. Okay, in case an institute doesn't have a dedicated facility or infrastructure at its own, student or faculty can reach nearest incubation facilities in other higher education institutes or other incubation centers. Next is product ownership rights for technologies and develop that institute. This is also very, very important because if you have an innovative idea in your mind, then you are going to nurture or convert that idea into a product. Then once you place the product in the public domain, then it's easy to copy and someone may misuse it. Okay, then because other person, just it's easy to copy it and develop a new innovative thing, okay, based on your develop a product. Okay, for that you need to protect your innovative idea and your process for developing the product. Okay, that that we call it as intellectual property rights. Okay, it's a negative right to the intellect by protecting your idea, because having intellectual property, it's an intangible property. Okay, but you are going to have a right on your invention. Okay, to have a intellectual property rights on your innovative developed product, it may be process or product, then it must be a new original and should have a novelty. Okay, then once you develop the invention, okay, by it may be invention or innovation. Here innovation nothing but a existing product or process you are going to implement or optimize it to a new product, or you may develop to increase its efficiency or productivity. Yeah, that we call it as innovation, by adding new features or a new composition. Okay, then if you come to the invention, okay, which is not exist so far, then you are going to develop your own, okay, newly. Yeah, that we call it as invention. Yeah, this is the difference between innovation, invention. Both can be protected under intellectual property right. Okay, here to have that IPR at the institution level, because employee of the organization or institute is going to work for the institution and paid by the institution or organization, so that institution and employee or inventor, yeah, the person who is going to work on idea and developing the product, they will become the inventor, and institution is going to fund and provide the facilities. Okay, then organization will become an applicant. Okay, then both will have the rights on the developed innovative product or the invention. Next, organizational capacity, human resources, and incentives. Here, to encourage the student, staff, and faculty, organization should have the organizational capacity, human resource, and incentives. Now, it means that first and foremost thing, to drive the startup and incubation, institute should have the experienced faculty, the person who is from industry background or maybe was an entrepreneur, okay? And should have the attitude towards the innovation and startup. Here, some of the relevant faculty members with fair exposure and interest should be deputed for training to promote innovation and entrepreneurship activity, to achieve better engagement of staff in entrepreneurial activities. Institution policy on career development as staff should be developed with constant upskilling. Okay, these are the organizational capacity and human resources. And come to the next slide, incentives. Here, some of the relevant faculty members with prior exposure, okay, in order to attract and retain right people at the institution to run innovation entrepreneurship for a long run, then the institution should have the reward system for the staff, may include sabbatical, the office last phase for entrepreneurial activities and reduced teaching loads, awards, trainings, etc. Okay, for recognition of the stakeholders, may include offering user facilities and services, okay, such for shared for teachers fellowship and associateship. The next one is creating innovation pipeline and pathway for entrepreneurs at institute level. Yeah, to ensure exposure of maximum students to innovation. Pre-institute activities at their early stage. To start up the pathway from ideation to innovation to market, as I told you earlier, here they should have a mechanism or device at the institution level, okay, to nurture idea to innovation into market. Okay, here by spreading awareness among students, faculty, staff about value of entrepreneurship, and its role in career development or employability to be part of the institutional entrepreneurial agenda. Okay, while framing the policy at the institutional level about NISP, then see, the NISP 2019 mainly focusing on policy framing at the institutional level, okay, between organization, student, and faculty. Okay, because we're keeping all financial and organizational support, then employees' contribution, okay, to drive the innovation entrepreneurship at the institution level. Okay, you need to have a multi-directional focus. Okay, that should be included in the innovation policy at the institution level. Okay, that is what here. Students also should be taught that innovation, that is technology, process, or business innovation, is a mechanism to solve the problem of the society and customer or consumer. Okay, here entrepreneurs should innovative focus on the market nature, because there is a problem, then you need to you are going to find the solution to the problem to solve the customer or society. See, if you develop any innovative product, okay, it should be used by the either customers or the industry. Otherwise, it is of no use to develop. Okay, here before going to take a idea, then you need to empathize on the problem statement, then ideate, then after brainstorming your idea, then you go for developing the prototype. Once you develop the prototype, then you are going to test and implement and supply to the customer or the industry. Then industry, again, you are going to get the feedback from the end user. Then again, you are going to change the features or the properties based on the feedback received from the end user or the industry. Then again, you are going to develop the product, then implement it in the market to run the successful business. Next, norms for faculty startup under innovation policy at the institution level. Okay, for better coordination of the entrepreneurial activities, your norms for faculty to do startups should be created by the institute. Only those technologies should be taken for faculty startups which originate from within the same institute. Because you'll have ideation hackathon, then you are going to select the innovative ideas and market potential ideas to implement. Then after, once you select those, then faculty can also involve with the students, or faculty himself can start, or a staff himself can start his own, okay, at the institution level. The role of faculty may vary from being an owner, a direct promoter, mentor, or consultant, or as a board member of the startup. Because now, usually, earlier institutions will not allow employee to go out or work with other organization or any startup once you join any organization. But now AICT amending the policy is that faculty can also start a startup while working in any institution or an organization, okay, by their own or like students or any startup. Institute should work on developing a policy on conflict of interest to ensure that the regular duties of the faculty don't suffer owing to either own or involvement in the startup activities. Yeah, because usually faculty should be engaged in teaching and as well as in R&D or in startup activities. Okay, then assigned work should not be hampered. Okay, then that you need to balance. Okay, then assigning the duties to the faculty also. Your faculty startup may consist of faculty members alone or with students. Okay, sir, go to next slide. Faculty startup may consist of faculty members alone or students or with faculty other institutes or alumni or other entrepreneurs. Okay, in case of faculty or staff holds the executive or managerial position for more than 3 months, okay, in startup, then they will go on sabbatical leave without pay, that is LOP basis, or utilize existing leave. Okay, that is also permissible from the institute. The faculty must clearly separate and distinguish ongoing research at the institute from the work conducted at the startup or company. Because once involved in the startup or company, the faculty will have more responsibility to drive. Because as I told you, one part is to achieve the technical know-how, and other is finance, and next is market. Okay, here that startup itself will have more interdisciplinary tasks. So that if you involve in too many tasks or activities, then it's a bit difficult to balance and execute all the tasks. Pedagogy and learning intervention for entrepreneurship development. Here, just for referring the available resources and taking the subject what you are usually practicing conventional type of teaching. Now, since technology is advancing day by day, okay, it may not be sufficient. So that I need to adopt pedagogy and learning interventions of multidisciplinary learning using mentors, labs, case studies, games, etc. in place of traditional lecture-based delivery. Okay, because as you know, nowadays too many advanced things are going in industries and R&D sectors, but still in academics, you are studying and teaching at the basic levels or old subjects, but it is required. Fundamentals are required, but still you need to have a exposure to advanced or newer technologies, which is developing day-to-day scenario in the market. Okay. Yeah. For implementing pedagogy and learning interventions, students have to have a student plus bodies, departments at the institution level. That includes boot camps, workshops, awards, etc. These bodies would be involved in institutional strategy planning to ensure enhancement of the students' thinking and responding ability. Okay, because that is what that higher education institutes, AICT and UGC, focusing on innovation and startup at the students' level, because students will have a different thinking capability at the stage. If you nurture a student innovative idea into a product, then it will be very useful to run the successful business and raise the economy in the country. Because now so many countries' economy will be based on the innovation of the such countries. Okay, here actually in our country supposed to implement these kind of things 20 years back. Okay, nevertheless now AICT has implemented. At least if you try towards this one, because India is having a more intellect resource compared to other countries, because of country's policies and lack of facilities, you are lagging in innovation and entrepreneurship. Okay, okay. Next slide of pedagogy and learning intervention. The institute should start annual innovation entrepreneurship award to recognize outstanding ideas, successful enterprises, and contributors for promoting innovation enterprises ecosystem within the institute. Of course, then only you can identify the good ideas. So you have the boot camp and hackathon, okay, by having innovation entrepreneurship award. Then for creating awareness among the students and teaching methods, should include case studies on business failure and real life experience reports by startups. Because in giving the talk and talking about innovation entrepreneurship, it's easy to give the lecture on it, but if you want to become an entrepreneur, it's not so easy, because you need to have a lot of skill sets and strength, and also you need to face weaknesses within us. Okay. Next point is collaboration, co-creation, business relationship, and knowledge exchange. Okay. Here, to run the innovation entrepreneurship in long run, then you should have the collaboration and co-creation between the institute and researchers and business relationship with customers and other different companies, and also exchanging the knowledge. That is also very, very important. Okay, institute should find the potential partners, the resource organizations, then MSMEs, social enterprises, schools, alumni, professional bodies, and entrepreneurs to support entrepreneurship and co-design the program. Go to the next slide. Yeah, stakeholder. Yeah, to encourage co-creation, bi-directional flow, exchange of knowledge and people should ensure between institutes such as incubators, science park, etc. Institutes should organize networking events for better engagement of collaborations and should open up the opportunities for staff, faculty, and students to allow constant flow of ideas and knowledge through meetings, workshops, space for collaboration, lectures, etc. A mechanism should be developed by the institute to capitalize on the knowledge gained for the collaborations, because that is very, very important. Because in present scenario, we are just working parallelly is a bit difficult, because to have advanced technology, you know, you need to have a multidisciplinary research, and you need to develop the automation kind of things, because nowadays all the things are based on IoT and machine learning based. Okay, if you take any mechanical, electrical, electronics, and computer science, now all together, so that if you have a such kind of R&D and innovation to develop the product, then it's easy to drive a successful business in the market. Next, entrepreneurial impact assessment. You need to assess the impact of the entrepreneurship at the institution level. Okay, yeah, those initiatives such as pre-incubation, incubation, entrepreneurship education should be performed regularly using well-defined evaluation parameters, such as monitoring and evaluation of knowledge exchange initiatives, encouragement of all departments and faculty in the entrepreneurial teaching and learning should be assessed. Then how many startups started from the incubation or the institution level, because that also you need to monitor, and satisfaction of participants, new business relationships created by the institute should be recorded and used for impact assessment. Okay. Then impact should also be measured for the support system provided by the institute to the student entrepreneurs, faculty, and staff for pre-incubation, incubation, IPR protection, industry linkages, exposure to entrepreneur ecosystem. Okay. Based on that, the formulation of strategy and impact assessment should go hand in hand. The information on impact of the activity should be actively used while developing and reviewing the entrepreneurial strategy. Okay, these are the points mentioned in the AICT-NIST policy 2019. Okay, while framing the institutional innovation and entrepreneurship policy or startup policy, okay, we need to focus on these points and trying to implement in the policy. Okay, it will be useful to the institute as well as to the faculty, students, and staff of any organization or the institute. Okay, thank you. Any questions, please ask.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful talk. Request participants to ask any questions to Dr. Shivana sir.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thanks for giving an opportunity to deliver the bit knowledge about AICT and NIST 2019 policy. Okay, thank you. Thank you all.
Dear participants.
Hello, okay, sir. Can you hear me, sir? Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible. Please go ahead.
Sir, I have a question. Shivana, sir, can I have a question, sir?
Yeah, please.
So, as a beginner for NISP, what are the initial stages that we need to undergo to start up with NISP, sir?
At the institution level, you need to frame the policy.
Okay, sir.
Policy about innovation and entrepreneurship.
Okay, sir.
Then based on that, you need to establish incubation, which involves pre-incubation. Pre-incubation, nothing but, okay, suppose students come with an idea, a student or faculty. Okay, then you are going to support them in terms of doing the literature on that innovative idea, how to convert or nurture that idea, and how to take it further for defining the problem, then ideation to solve that problem, to further going for prototype. Okay, that is, that level you call it as pre-incubation. Incubation is the thing you are going to provide the space and facility to develop the product and to start a startup. That is incubation. Okay. Then you will go for acceleration. That is nothing but you are going to connect between the incubation and to the industry.
Okay.
And to the market.
Okay.
Okay, so sales stage is how to work.
Okay. So any barrier with respect to IPR, sir, because we're converting our idea into a product, what is the any limitations with respect to IPR, sir?
Sir, there is no limitation for IPR because no, if it is innovative or invention which is not exist in the public domain, yeah, that can be protected. Okay, it may be, you see, in IPR where there are four types. One is patent. Okay, patent involves either process or product. Okay, and design registration. Design registration based on its shape and configuration, lines, colors, and ornamentation, that can be protected under design registration under IP Act 2000 from IP India. And copyright, okay, if it is original write-up or literary work, dramatic or cinematography, that can be protected under copyright. Okay, so other one is trademark. Okay, you are going to develop a symbol for your company or develop for your own, and you're going to protect it. It is not existing in the market.
Okay.
Because most of the times, what you call it as branding. Okay, okay, it may be a symbol or letters or character that can be protected under trademark act. Okay, so okay. That is very, very important. It is easy to, if you have the IPR or patent protection, then you'll have a more value on your commercialization of your invention.
Okay.
Okay. Here, if you are not able to start a startup at your institution level, in your incubation or in your R&D, then if somebody or outside or any industry person wants to do business with using your technology or technical know-how, you can commercialize it by transferring the technology.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Hello. Yeah, ma'am.
Hello. Good evening, everyone. Kindly, if for example, I'm from the design field. If a student designs some logo, will that copyright will be by the name of the institute or it will be in the name of the student?
See, if you use the institute facility, then institute and the inventor. If you are creating, since you are the employee of the institute. If the student, then again there will be a policy between institute and the student. What will be the percentage sharing?
But after some time, when student pass out, he goes on the. It will be continue with the institute or it will be the student.
Both will have the right, because while you are the student at your institute, he developed.
Mm-hmm.
So here are two things. Sharing the percentage between the organization and the inventor. Inventor may be student, staff, or faculty. Okay. Then, if you are using the facility of your institute, then percentage will be vary. If you are not using any facility at all at the institution level, then inventor will have more percentage than the institute.
Because
that, again, it depends on the institute and the inventor.
Because when the student is under the umbrella of the institute, student will be. But after when he passed out, I think.
Yeah, but as per AICT NISP policy, you have to give more share, more percentage towards the inventor. maybe student or faculty or staff. Okay, that is what in the first slide itself, they have mentioned that there should not be any stringent control system. Again, it depends on the institute policy. Yeah, that is what, while framing the this one innovation and entrepreneurship or startup policy, okay, where there should be a mixed expertise from the startup, from the industry, from the academia, okay, and from the entrepreneurship. So, all together, sit and brainstorm to how to make a how to frame the policy at the institution level, because this is very, very important. Because same question I asked when I met the innovation director at Delhi, Abhay Dere sir and Pandey sir, and also most of the times now most of the times whenever I'm meeting Chancellor of Central University of Orissa, because the Chancellor is very close to Central Limited Ministries and others, keep on discussing about the innovation and sharing of percentage of share between the inventor and the institution level. Because then only is possible to drive the entrepreneurship at the institution level. Because no institute is going to provide the facility. Without facilities, just having an idea, it's a bit difficult to nurture that idea into a product, right? If you use the facility, then institute percent will have the rise to have a share. Hello.
Hello. Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, again, it depends, madam. Because, no, see, when the student studying in the institute, at that time you are going to register, right, under IP.
Mm-hmm.
If it is a trademark or patent, or copyright. Okay, the day, on the day you are going to file the application, no, that will be the, your priority date. Okay, it may be granted after 3 years or 4 years, but the day on which you are going to file the application, that will be considered.
Mm-hmm. Oh, is there any financial assistance policy for the students if they are creating their own all this thing?
Yeah, as per ACTNSC policy, they are focusing and advising all the institute to have a 1% budget of the financial year from the institute, and okay, for providing a basic facilities at the institution level. Then later stage, so many this one, no, investment firms will be there, like angel investors and venture capitalists. Okay, you can approach them, because if you want to reach to the angel investors and venture capitalists or fund to raise the fund, then you have to have a minimum TRL level 6 to 8, sometimes 7 to 9 also. Okay, the product right to be implemented in the market. If you reach that stage, then you can reach out to the angel investors or the venture capitalists. Because no, 2 years in India, there is no depth to have a innovative idea in India. Main thing is that to nurture that innovative idea into a product, okay, then where there is a financial implication. Okay, who is going to fund to develop the product? Okay, then that is where our innovators are lagging. Okay. Then for that, either institute have to bear or have to write the proposal to the funding agency. So many funding agencies are there. Again, it depends. While funding, so many central government funding agencies such as DSC, AICT, and other ministries, departments, first they'll give preference to the government autonomy institutions, then for the private institutions.
We are coming under government only, so I think further details can Abhay Jerek is dealing with this, no, innovative cell.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, thank you so much, sir, for your guidance.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am.
Any questions from other participants?
Okay.
VVC, actually we provide entire fee for IPR filing. What about in other institutes? In your institute at least, CMIRT?
Pardon me, sir?
Sir, for IPR filing, whatever the fees is there, no, that will be borne by the institute. The students, if they want to file for any IPR, so especially they are filing for patents, entire fee will be borne by the institute, sir.
Then who will be the applicant, sir?
Applicant is the institute.
Then
students are the inventors.
Yeah, institute will have the rights on that patent application.
Yes, sir. We have IPR cell. And also we have incubation facility for our students. It's provided free of cost.
Oh, okay, nice. Again, it depends on institute.
Yes, sir, you are right. Just for the information of the participants, I mentioned this point, sir.
Again, it depends. Simply you cannot file all the applications by bearing the cost of the patent application, because where there are different stages are there for filing the application, starting from just filing the application, then request for publication, then request for examination. Okay, sir. Stage you need to pay fees, prosecution fees. If it is really innovative and having market potential, then any IP cell or incubation can bear the cost. Again, that depends on the institute management decision, like the middle management.
Right, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions from other participants?
Yes. Shall we wind up, sir?
Yes, sir, please.
Thanks a lot, sir, for briefing about some of the important factors like strategies and governance of NISP, creating innovation pipeline through NISP, NISP policy, incubation infrastructure, financial strategies and management, institutional infrastructure, and converting idea into a product or a patent, norms for faculty startups and the student startups. So your informations were so highlighting about the startup implementation of NISP in our institution. On behalf of Vidyavarga College of Engineering, my profuse thanks to Dr. Shivan and DM for the resource person, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you a lot for giving an opportunity.
It's a pleasure, sir. On behalf of team of IIC, I profusely thank the principal, Dr. B. Sadashivay Gowda, sir, for being the part of this event. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you.
I convey my sincere thanks to Dr. G.P. Kesar, Dean, R&D, and President of Institutional Innovation Council, IIC. Thanks a lot for the participation, sir.
Thank you, sir.
My sincere thanks to the deans of various sections, HODs of various departments, and all my dear colleagues for being the part of this event. Thanks a lot for attending the session on briefing of NISP. Thanks a lot. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.